the moment, I'm actually interested just in the idea of field identification of insects, which is becoming more possible because there's more books about it, and there's internet references and so on. So it's possible now, in a way, for people to identify insects by sight in a way that was not possible 10 years ago. Cricket actually rubs its wings together, whereas grasshoppers rub their legs together to make the sound. And the cicada, I think, makes its sound. Cicada is completely unrelated to those other insects, and I believe that the cicada makes its sound is by sort of vibrating its thorax. So sound production clearly evolved multiple times in insect evolution. Ability to produce sounds evolved in different ways, in different lineages.
I've been asked to illustrate what a cricket might look like in the future. And, their wings will evolve to produce higher volume sound, much like a phonograph. And with the nanotechnology that exists at the time in the future, their bodies will be augmented to serve mankind, and so the satellite dishes will, provide surveillance data for whoever needs it, and they'll breed solely on, the attractive patterns of circles and rectangles, and their song is not nearly as pleasant as it is now.
The limits of science, or that even if something can be explained rationally or scientifically, it doesn't explain, let's say, its evocative nature or its capacity to provoke feelings in us. I mean, you could study cricket chirping for a lifetime, but it wouldn't explain the sentimental attraction that we have to that sound.
Well, I like your philosophy. It's very interesting. It reminds me of something. Have you ever heard of the term numinous?
No, I can't say that I have.
Well, it's the feeling of divinity among oneself. It gets you in touch with your inner spirit, and it reminds you of your primal brain. It could set you free. The greatest way to get in touch with this is through nature.
Like you smoke it or eat a mushroom or something?
No, you just sit and you take in the beautiful world before it was touched by man.
Yeah, so I don't understand. You're saying I should try this now, or do I just nod in agreement?
No, I'm just saying that I would like you to see the similarity between this and crickets. Because, crickets are a part of nature.
Yeah, I don't think you're being very helpful right now.
Oh,
so.
No, I'm agreeing with you. Crickets are definitely a part of what you're speaking of.
Lullabies for your grandkids, a motherfucking boys banging and make me feel. We'll be catching your foul balls, you know how fairies feel. We are down at the beach, babies from the Ferris wheel here. Dog is shame, down the way to Irish parade. And man, I reckon we get the Ferris deal just like you step in line.
It's hard to deny that impulse to want to be loved by myriads of women.
I think that the main reason that insects produce sound is to attract a mate, and so I think it's mostly the males that are chirping to attract the female. I don't know whether insects chirp or make sound to announce their own territory the way that birds do.
But don't touch, because if you touch, you're going to get your hand, like, just ripped off. Just bad news. So it's a fun tightrope to walk of, you know, it's like stepping in the lion's cage, but make sure you don't smell like blood. Because if they know you got blood in your pockets, you're definitely going to be, you know, trudging to the North Pole before you're able to get that scent off your chest. I've arisen and awoken from my my vestibule of, what would they say?
See, that's why I don't like people. Because sometimes, you know, animals are so much better. They give you this unconditional love or hate. It's all misunderstood. Unless they're a fucking mammal. You can't tell if they're happy or sad. You just can pretend that they are!
Interpreted just for gaining a man. match one primal self with very little thought. We need to just appreciate our biology. Our spirits. What do they tell us? We should know, but we have too many neurotic thoughts distracting us from our primal thoughts.